My friend is looking to start a mobile dog grooming business. They've got some supplies, but there's a lot they need to purchase before they can start. All totaled, it's going to cost about $100,000 to get the business started. So needless to say, it's going to take some investment. Fortunately, my friend knows a local banker who is willing to help secure a small business loan. Just like other businesses, banks are motivated to be profitable, and loans are an important part of generating revenue to maximize profits. Now, in our previous lesson, we discussed how banks have a reserve requirement that forces them to keep a certain amount of money on hand to cover transactions and withdrawals. Anything above that reserve requirement, banks are free to make loans, like my friend's small business loan, using funds held in bank accounts. Some other loans include auto loans, mortgages, home improvement loans, and plenty of other options. Businesses and individuals apply for a loan. The size of that loan is the principal. For my friend's small business loan, the principal would be $100,000. Banks then look over the loan application and decide whether or not to make the loan. If the loan gets approved, businesses and individuals agree to pay the principal back over a specified period of time, along with interest. Interest is the cost of borrowing money. As the loan is paid back, the bank gives some account holders a small amount of the interest as payment for letting the bank use their deposits for loans. This allows those account holders to increase the amount of money they have saved. Banks then keep the rest of the interest paid on those loans. Some of that can then be loaned out to generate even more interest. And some of that money represents the profit banks make. In 2022, American banks made over $200 billion in profit. How do loans benefit banks, consumers, and people with bank accounts? Pause the video while you answer the question. The loan process benefits people with bank accounts because they can earn interest on money they have saved. Consumers can borrow money to make investments or purchases, and banks can be profitable through interest payments. Banks have been loaning money to businesses, individuals, and even governments for centuries. For a long time, it was often commodity money like gold and silver coins. However, the rise of fiat money has made the process of lending money much easier for banks. There is generally more money than currency in an economy, usually stored in bank accounts. This makes it easier to move money between accounts and institutions. For example, when my friend's small business loan is approved, they won't be given $100,000 in currency. The bank will give my friend a check or transfer that money electronically into the bank account for my friend's business. Fiat money is also easier to repay. Let's say my friend's monthly payment on their small business loan is $1,000. In a system powered by commodity money like gold, my friend would need to be able to access $1,000 of that commodity. That would require customers paying in gold coins every time my friend groomed their dogs. With fiat money, my friend can be paid in currency like paper money, or other forms of money like checks, or electronic transfers like debit cards or payment apps. And because fiat money is easier to repay, banks have greater lending power. If a bank had $1 million of commodity money loaned out, they would need to wait until that had been repaid to lend it out again. But with fiat money, banks can lend out money they might not have right then, but expect to be repaid. How does that work? If there is $1 million of fiat money loaned out and the bank knows that each month $50,000 will be repaid, the bank can then make loans on a portion of that $50,000. Okay, let's take a moment to check in. Banks use loans and the interest collected on those loans to be profitable. Why would banks prefer an economy that relies on fiat money? When you've answered that, we'll meet up to go over the answer. Banks prefer fiat money because it is easier for them to loan out money and collect interest. And because they can loan out more money, they can collect more interest, increasing their profitability. And while this process benefits banks and their customers, what is the benefit of loaning out money to the economy in general? Pause the video while you try to predict the answer. If you think back to our previous unit, you'll remember that gross domestic product measures economic growth over a period of time. And part of the calculation for GDP includes consumption and investment. Well, banks loaning out money helps increase consumption and investment, leading to economic growth. This process allows capital to be used more efficiently in an economy. Banks are able to pool money from many depositors and loan it out to folks like my friend. Businesses and consumers have access to more money. Imagine if my friend had to go to dozens or even hundreds of different individuals and businesses to borrow small amounts of money, and each person lending money had different interest rates and timeframes that they needed to be repaid. All of that would make borrowing money more difficult and time-consuming, meaning it might slow economic growth. Consumers who've been loaned money can use it to purchase goods and services. My friend used part of her small business loan to purchase supplies like pet shampoo and nail clippers. Ordinary folks use money from loans to purchase cars, homes, and pay for home improvement projects. Plus, businesses can use loans to invest in their business. My friend was able to purchase a van, a pretty vital tool for a mobile pet groomer. All of this consumption and investment gets factored into GDP, creating economic growth. Okay, pause the video for a moment to revise your answer to the question I asked at the beginning of the section. Let's take a few minutes to discuss what we covered today. Banks use money deposited by account holders to loan to businesses and individuals. These loans are then paid back with interest. The interest collected is paid to the bank's account holders, loaned out to other consumers, and eventually is factored into the profitability of the bank. Fiat money has made this process easier and more profitable for banks and helped contribute to economic growth. Now, before we go, I encourage you to take a look at our financial literacy course that goes into deeper detail about how banks determine whether to approve a loan or not, and how they determine what the interest rate for a loan is going to be. Tomorrow, we're going to examine how governments use monetary policy to ensure the economic health of a nation. Till then, keep investing in yourself one lesson at a time. See you next time. Hey, hey.